just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you.
Lama Tenzin is an ordinary Tibetan monk with an extraordinary mission. For the first time in 7 years, Lama Tenzin is taking 11 children on an incredible journey back to their roots. In the year 2001, he rescued these children from miserable living conditions in Upper Dolpo, one of the most remote regions of Nepal. Lama Tenzin built a home for the children in India and started the Children's Education Development Society, the CED, where they could receive health care and education in a nourishing environment.
The mission is special. We are taking care for the children. He is special in the Himalaya border region and who is totally hopeless. He's out from the communities, out from the caste. So those are the children we rescue and give the opportunity to, through the education, to stand in the communities.
These children have not seen their homes since the day they left for the CED. For some, the separation has lasted as long as 7 years. Their parents hold on to the bright hope that these children will return home to uplift their communities one day. On this journey, Lama Tenzin intends to keep two promises. First, he has promised the children that they will be in their parents' arms again. And second, he promises their families that they will see how education has changed the lives of the children. Like thousands of other expeditions that begin here, this journey has all the excitement and danger of a classic Himalayan adventure. Mountain passes at altitudes of 18,000 feet, extreme weather conditions, and even the ever-present possibility of death. This expedition will proceed on foot for 30 days. They will need to take everything they need with them, including 30 days' worth of food, equipment, medical supplies, and gifts for the village children they will be meeting along the way.
Pain throws your heart to the ground. Love turns the whole thing around. No, it won't all go there.
The children of Dolpo were born on the borders of Nepal, India, and Tibet.
And I'm so excited to meet my parents.
Commitment. We are definitely these children. After 7 years, they're going back to village. And my responsibility, my commitment to has to go back to meet with their families. That's my commitment.
Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Hold on and I'll find you.
I'm hanging on by a thread, and all I'm clinging to is prayers. And every breath is like a battle. I feel like I ain't come prepared. And death's knocking on the front door. Pain's creeping through the back. Fear's crawling through the windows, waiting for them to attack. They say don't get bitter, get better. I'm working on switching them letters. But tell God I'ma need a whole lot of hope keeping it together. I'm smiling in everyone's face. I'm crying whenever they leave the room. They don't know the battle I face. They don't understand what I'm going through. The world trying to play with my soul. I'm just trying to find where to go. I'm trying to remember the way. I'm trying to get back to my home.
Up ahead, a landslide of massive boulders blocks the road. It will take days to clear the way. Dynamite will be needed, but it will take another day to get explosives to the site. Again, Lama Tenzin refuses to wait or turn back.
I've been looking for a way out, but I'll settle for a peace of mind. Picking up the pieces of my life and hoping that I put together something right. Tell me all I got is all I need. Tell me you.
Pema Lamo is 15 years old. When she left her village of Karang to join Lama Tenzin, she was 10 years old and could not read or write. If she had stayed on in Karang, she might have been married and with child by the age of 14.
I am all the children of CED. I'm take care of all children. This is my duty.
Karma left his village with Lama Tenzin when he was 3 years old. Back in their villages in Dalpo, the children would be carrying back-breaking loads every day. Children such as these, who were from the lower caste of society, would spend their childhood working without time for school, dreams, or ambitions.
I have to learn education and knowledge from CED because we all have no education, and they need doctor, and they need some pilot, and they need some artist, they need some beautician, the other else. And when I grew up, I became into a doctor.
In Jomsom, Lama Tenzin recruits porters, but they are reluctant. They will need 18 horses and donkeys, and 3 men to carry 4 sacks of potatoes, 8 sacks of rice and wheat flour, other food supplies, and camping equipment. A bargain is struck. The expedition will depart from Jomsom in 2 days' time. It was on a summer pilgrimage that Lama Tenzin and his brothers first visited Dalpo. They wanted to go somewhere that would feel like Tibet, for they were Tibetans. Inexperienced trekkers from the city, they got lost and ran out of food. They were offered shelter in a Dalpo village. What they saw there changed their lives.
And she said, please take my child to India for the education.
In the Himalayan region, they have a lot of girls. Mostly girls, they have a less opportunity to go to school, and they are starting their work on the, when they're 4 years old until the 13, 14, and then after 13, 14, they have to getting married.
Right then, Lama Tenzin decided that he had to do something for the children of Dalpo.
It's not like somebody who can guide me to say you have to do these things. It just came up and I just follow because I feel I like it and I believe like it's the more important than my religious.
The problem for the porter, they don't want to go out there. So that's why, you know, we have to camp here today.
I don't know where else to go, and I don't know what else to do.
No, don't let the fear make you feel like you can't fight this on your own. You know I'll be there for you no matter where you go. You'll never be alone. No, just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold.
The children have been walking for up to 10 hours every day for 4 days. Today, they take time to rest. Lama Tenzin maintains their CED schedule of chanting and writing or drawing entries in their journals daily.
And this is my house, this is my kitchen, and my father and mother make food for me.
When I was a child, it's really, we don't have any kind of like dreams. Because my family has a lot of child, and every single child has a very less opportunity to be study, but still my mother worked hard to give all the equals education.
But that's one of the two main highest journey before we get to Targa.
Pampa cooks traditional Tibetan bread over the fire. This will help the children store energy for the following day's challenges. They are all in high spirits, even as they negotiate steep paths of rock and make their way across ice-cold, raging waters.
fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Just hold.
Lama Tenzin returns to Dolpo every year, looking for other children to rescue. Instead of pursuing a life of meditation in a monastery, he devotes himself to the children. 13,500 feet above sea level, the highest villages on earth are here in Charco Valley. After traveling on foot for 6 days, they arrive in Charco Bat. This is the village of Chumi Lama and her mother, Karma Doma.
So today
maybe she's not doing this thing. Maybe hopefully maybe she's going to be a great teacher to help all the children to not like child laborers.
Lama Tenzin holds a special agreement with the children at CED. After they complete their studies, they will be given work and earn an income at the CED home. Then, they are to spend 6 months of each year back in their own villages, teaching and helping their neighbors. For now, Lama Tenzin instructs them on this important mission in simple ways. He teaches them to show simple acts of kindness towards the children they meet. They have carried school supplies with them all this way to distribute to local schools.
Hello. When I am 10 years old, Lama Tenzin came from Dolpo. Then we 10 children take set house and many Lama Tenzin brought so many things like towels, clothes, and then we shower and clothes, and we are so happy.
The trails they walk upon become treacherously thin. The pack horses are sent ahead to reduce the risk of the children getting pushed off the trail. They must exercise caution at all times.
Sorrowing sometimes, pouring from the skies, stories dark and cold, chill you to the bone, shattered feet I fall, lonely rivers call. Try to go my way alone, searching for my home.
Karma feels the toll of days of trekking with only breakfast and dinner to fuel his young body. A severe headache brings him to tears. Some of the other children also complaining of headaches. It is the altitude taking an effect on their bodies. These children were born in the highest villages in the world, but they have lived in lower altitudes for so long. It will take time for their bodies to readjust. Lama Tenzin takes Karma in his arms and does his best to make Karma feel better, reassuring him that all will be well by morning.
And I've been down some roads that were hard, but I figured out that I want you with me, or I won't get too far. I won't get too far.
wet and hungry, Pema Lamo is stricken with hypothermia, one of the many risks trekkers are exposed to in the Himalayas. Her body is losing heat. If her body temperature drops further, she will fall into a stupor, and her body will slowly begin to shut down. Lift her spirits with songs and silly antics. With a smile comes to her lips, they know she is out of harm's way.
Solitary vision till